Hello and welcome to Amazing Aircraft. Imagine a helicopter that could outfly any other, shoot missiles and rockets from multiple turrets and hardpoints, and perform aerobatic stunts like a plane. It sounds like science fiction, right? Well, it almost became reality in the 1960s when Lockheed developed the AH-56 Cheyenne, the most advanced attack helicopter ever built. So why did this revolutionary machine never enter service? What happened to the Cheyenne program? In this video, we will explore the history, design, and fate of the Lockheed AH-56 Cheyenne. Ready to dive into its story? Buckle up and let's go. The story of the Cheyenne begins in the early 1960s when the U.S. Army needed a new way to support its ground troops in the Vietnam War. The Army had been using modified transport helicopters, such as the UH-1 Iroquois, to carry weapons and provide fire support. However, these helicopters were slow, vulnerable, and limited in firepower and range. The Army needed a dedicated attack helicopter that could escort the transport helicopters, engage enemy targets, and survive in hostile environments. In 1962, a special board led by General Hamilton Howse reviewed the Army's aviation requirements, recommending an air mobile division supported by armed helicopters. This led to the launch of the Advanced Aerial Fire Support System program, setting demanding specifications for a new helicopter: a cruise speed of 195 knots, a dash speed of 220 knots, and the ability to hover out of ground effect at 6,000 feet on a hot day. It also required a sophisticated navigation and fire control system and a tandem cockpit for the pilot and the gunner. Several companies were invited to submit proposals, among them Bell, Sikorsky, and Lockheed. Lockheed proposed the CL-840, a rigid-rotor compound helicopter with both a pusher propeller and a conventional tail rotor. In 1966, Lockheed was announced as the winner of the AAFSS program and awarded a contract for 10 prototypes. The new helicopter was designated the AH-56A and named Cheyenne. The Cheyenne combined the best features of fixed-wing and rotary-wing aircraft. It had an aerodynamic fuselage with retractable landing gear, small wings, and a four-bladed rigid main rotor. It was powered by a General Electric T-64 turboshaft engine, driving a pusher propeller at the rear, the main rotor, and the tail rotor. The pusher propeller provided thrust and directional control, while the main rotor provided lift and stability. At high speeds, the wings and the windmilling main rotor also generated lift, reducing aerodynamic load. The cockpit layout was unusual, with the pilot in the front seat and the gunner in the rear seat. This provided the pilot better visibility and control, and allowed the gunner to rotate with the weapon turrets. The cockpit featured an advanced navigation and fire control suite, including a helmet-mounted sight system for the pilot and a periscope sight system for the gunner. The gunner's seat, sighting system, and firing controls could rotate to keep the gunner facing the same direction as the gun turret being controlled. The Cheyenne was heavily armed, with two weapon turrets mounted at the nose and belly of the aircraft. The nose turret could mount either a 40mm grenade launcher or a 7.6 2mm minigun and could rotate 100 degrees from the centerline. The belly turret had a 30mm automatic cannon with 360 degrees of rotation. The Cheyenne also had six external hardpoints for carrying rockets, missiles, or fuel tanks. It could carry up to six TOW anti-tank missiles. The Cheyenne was expected to enter service in the early 1970s and revolutionize the role of helicopters in warfare. However, its development was plagued by technical problems, political controversies, and tragic accidents. The complex and novel design posed many challenges, and the Army's requirements changed over time. The Cheyenne also faced opposition from the Air Force, which claimed the helicopter would infringe on its close air support mission. The end of the Vietnam War reduced the Army's need for a new attack helicopter, sealing the Cheyenne's fate. In 1972, the Army canceled the Cheyenne program after spending more than $400 million and building 10 prototypes. The Cheyenne never made it past the testing stage and never saw combat. The Army later initiated a new program for an advanced attack helicopter, which led to the development of the AH-64 Apache, a more conventional and less ambitious helicopter, but also more reliable and survivable. The Cheyenne had a rigid main rotor, low-mounted wings, and a pusher propeller. The rigid rotor allowed the Cheyenne to fly faster and more maneuverably than conventional helicopters. Unlike most helicopters, the Cheyenne's rotor blades did not flap or feather to adjust lift and thrust. Instead, rotor tilt was controlled through gyroscopic precession, reducing vibration and stress on the rotor system. The pusher propeller was driven by the General Electric T-64 engine, providing most of the thrust for forward flight, while the main rotor provided additional lift and stability. At high speeds, the wings and the pusher propeller reduced aerodynamic load on the rotor. The pusher propeller allowed the Cheyenne to slow down or accelerate without pitching the nose up or down, enhancing maneuverability and agility. The low-mounted wings spanned almost 27 feet and had 6 external hardpoints for carrying weapons and fuel tanks. These wings generated lift and forward flight, reducing the power required from the rotor and propeller. The wings had a slight anhedral angle, improving lateral stability and control. The Cheyenne had a 2-seat tandem cockpit with an advanced navigation and fire control suite. The pilot sat in the front seat and the gunner in the rear. The gunner station rotated to keep the gunner facing the same direction as the gun turret being controlled. The pilot had a helmet-mounted sight system for aiming weapons. The Cheyenne had 2 weapon turrets. The nose turret could rotate plus or minus 100 degrees from the aircraft's center line and could mount either a 40mm grenade launcher or a 7.62mm minigun, while the belly turret included a 30mm automatic cannon with 360 degrees of rotation. The Cheyenne could also carry pods of 3 BGM-71 Tau anti-tank missiles, 2.75-inch rockets in 7 rocket or 19 rocket launchers, and external fuel tanks on the wing hardpoints. The Cheyenne made its first flight on September 21, 1967, and soon demonstrated its impressive performance. It could fly faster than any other helicopter at the time, reaching speeds of over 370 kilometers per hour in level flight and 454 kilometers per hour in a dive. It could hover out of ground effect at 1,800 meters on a hot day, perform agile maneuvers such as loops, rolls, and spins, and carry a payload of 7,300 kilograms. It could fly for over 2 hours without refueling and had a combat radius of 460 kilometers. The Cheyenne also showed its firepower, accurately firing rockets, missiles, and cannons. However, the Cheyenne faced many challenges and setbacks during its flight testing. One major problem was the half-P hop, a vibration that occurred once per 2 rotor revolutions, causing the rotor to oscillate and strike the fuselage. This issue led to a fatal crash on March 12, 1969, killing the pilot. Lockheed modified the rotor and control systems to prevent the same problem from happening again, but the crash damaged the Cheyenne's reputation and schedule. The Army issued a cure notice to Lockheed, citing 11 technical problems and unsatisfactory progress on the program. The Army canceled the production contract, but kept the development contract in hopes of resolving the issues. Lockheed proposed an improved flight control system to reduce rotor oscillations, as well as steps for removing excess weight and addressing other minor issues in production helicopters. Lockheed also conducted wind tunnel testing and design modifications to improve the Cheyenne's stability and handling. One of the modifications was the installation of an ejection seat for the pilot, placed in the forward seat in place of the gunner station. The ejection seat fired downward and was intended to save the pilot in case of a catastrophic failure. Despite these efforts, political and military opposition, particularly from the Air Force, argued that the helicopter infringed on close air support missions and faced concerns about the high casualty rate of helicopters in Vietnam. The Army defended the Cheyenne, emphasizing the need for a fast and powerful helicopter. A special task force reevaluated the requirements, comparing the Cheyenne with the Bell 309 King Cobra and the Sikorsky S-67 Blackhawk. Despite concluding the Cheyenne was the best option with recommended changes, it was too late. The Army canceled the Cheyenne program on August 9, 1972, after spending over $700 million and producing 10 prototypes, citing its large size, inadequate night and all-weather capability, and outdated weapon systems. The Army decided to pursue a new advanced attack helicopter program, leading to the development of the AH-64 Apache, which entered service in the mid-1980s. Despite its cancellation, the AH-56 Cheyenne remains a fascinating example of innovative helicopter design. It showcased advanced engineering and technology, influencing future helicopter development. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, remember to like, share, and subscribe. The sky is not the limit, it's just the beginning. Thanks for watching, see you next time.